But Nick and I just ran the chute about an hour ago with the GoPro on the front of the boat. The GoPro didn't make it to the end of the chute.
Smarty, Eminem's brother. We got Magpie. We got football. And we got Brycey Boy. Yeah. And of course,
we don't have a name for Cliff yet, do we? All these trips are still other.
Just Cliff. Just Cliff. There you go. It's
just Cliff.
It's just Cliff. And Canwest Backpacker. We just hit the town of Wells. Oh my goodness. Washboards. So we're here now, a little closer to Bowron Lakes Park. And we've got some beautiful liquid sunshine.
Liquid sunshine, eh?
And Nick said it's gonna be sunny, see?
I told you.
No sooner did he say that. So.
Well, I mean.
But. Yeah.
It's sunny.
If you don't like the weather in the Caribou, wait
sunny,
10 minutes.
Sunny boy.
The sun? So hopefully the sun's going to come out. And Ryan, what did we see when we got here?
A bear.
What kind of bear?
A big one? No, it was actually a really small
medium size, but a grizzly bear nonetheless. So Ryan and I are in the hammocks. Cliff is in the shifter. And Magnus is in, and Bryce are in the marmot. And Nick's in the trusty old walrus, arch rival.
You should get Ryan that shirt.
Should film yeah. Okay. 2 kilometer portage from Kibby to Indian Point. This one is uphill right from the get-go. Halfway, it'll turn downhill, and then it's nice. Okay, I don't know how, I won't be centered in the shot, but we just finished the portage, 2 kilometers into Indian Point Lake. It was brutal. Muddy, full of ruts, logs, rocks. It just sucked. Flies, black flies, mosquitoes, no see-ems. So. But so far, we just had the one rain shower, so the rain's held off. Let me take off this good ugly hat. So. The rain's held off pretty much other than that one shower. But we're gonna head out here, do a little fishing, and try to get some firewood on this lake. There's a wood lot, so. That's it for now. Oh, the other thing, we found some other people are going for the same site we are tonight, so. Looks like we might be going farther. We might have another portage ahead of us. Another 1.6. We'll see. That or we may stop short today.
So Bryce, how was day number one?
Pretty good. It was a little bit tiring at first, but once we started going, it was got easier.
Yeah, those portages were brutal. The second one. Mm. All the mud holes and dips.
Especially
and
with that big mud hole. When we just went, we thought, like, that's just a mud hole. Then you hit it and it's like, holy crap.
Yeah.
And you end up fighting the dirt.
Yeah, we had to carry our canoes over it with 60 pounds of gear in them with the wheels on them. It was not fun.
While having packs in our bag.
Yeah. And Cliff's pack must weigh 60 pounds. I couldn't pick it up.
I think mine weighs more than his this trip. I don't know how.
I don't know. You guys didn't pack light, I guess.
Guess not.
We're lightweight backpackers, but we don't think about it when we're canoeing. We think, we're canoeing. Who cares?
Portages kill.
Anyways, we've made it to site. What is the site number, Nick? Do you remember?
I'll check right now with my handy-dandy map.
I'm thinking 6.
Actually, I think it's on the post down there.
Or is it 8?
I think you're wrong. I mean, it is 8.
8. Site number 8. At the end of Indian Point Lake. Ryan is about to filter some water.
Thank you, Sean, for the filter.
Yeah. And we've got the cabin here, so there's been thunder. I haven't seen any lightning, but there's been pretty loud thunder rolling. So we're going to stay here, hunker down. What time is it? It's like 12? 1? 1 o'clock. 1:20. So it's not that late in the day, but it's not worth it being out there in this stuff. We're on schedule.
Ryan, after you finish filtering water, could I borrow some for my granola?
So that's where we're at with day one. We'll try to film a bit more, but it's disgusting.
You gotta show them our setup when we set it up in the cabin.
Yeah, we're gonna set up. The boys are gonna sleep in the cabin. I may try to hang my hammock underneath this little awning here. Or I might use the tent just because it's so windy. So.
Yeah. I got some. Wait,
I'll check back with you later.
Oh, hell no.
Oh, Magnus!
Yeah. Explain to us how come your dad is boiling your water for you on his stove.
You know, not like I forgot a stove or anything.
Well, you said you packed it, but it didn't show up.
I remember packing it.
That's the greatest line I think I've ever heard. Well, here comes the wind again.
I had that.
What?
I remember packing, so I laid all my stuff out.
You laid it out.
Yeah.
Then he lost it.
Somehow, maybe forgot to pick it up, or maybe fell
out. I don't know, it's bright orange. It's like this big.
Yeah. Them cardinals work damn good. Okay, so it's the end of day one, and sat around, had some fun around the fire. The boys were goofing around a lot. Wind finally calmed down, but I already had the tent up, so it looks like sleeping on the ground tonight. Hopefully tomorrow won't be as windy, and I'll be able to get the hammock up and the tarp. So, yeah, end of day one. 7 more to go. See you guys tomorrow.
It's morning of day 2. And it's 20 after 6. There's a lot of mosquitoes trying to get in my tent. I don't hear any rain. I don't hear any wind. So I'm going to pack packed up my stuff in here and got out. See what the sky looks like. See what kind of day we're in for.
Finish Indian Point Lake, and then we're on to Isaac. Skies are looking kind of stormy, lots of low cloud, but so far it's not raining. So. All right, we're on Isaac Lake. We finished our last portage for the next 2 days, so. That one was another slightly brutal one. Lots of washouts and stuff. We managed to hit the wood lot. We loaded up with lots of wood. There's lots of people loading boats and we're all trying to get out of each other's way. And everyone's rushing, but we'll get down here and we'll find a spot where we can stop for lunch in a couple hours. Reload our boats. Push on as far as we can. Hopefully we can hit campsite 20 or 21 today. Oh, here they come. All right.
Wow, that was terrible.
We had about 15 kilometers of paddling today.
We want to stick to
it. Okay, well, until I check in next, we're on Isaac Lake. And it's just starting to spit a little bit, so. Yeah. Hopefully that's the only rain we get. Hopefully it doesn't pick up any more than this. Check in with you guys in an hour or so. Just past campsite 18. On our way to 20, the people that we were kind of racing for a site, they stopped and took 18, so that's good for us. Hopefully there's nobody between us and 20, and we can get into 20 and get the cabin. So it is still sprinkling, but it's not pouring. So we've been going for about two and a half hours on Isaac now. Finished the small arm and we're on to the main arm. Fished for a little bit. I got a bite and then nothing. So I'm going to get into camp, set up, and then I think I'm going to head back out on the lake and try to catch something. So far the fishing derby, Cliff 1, Mike nothing. The other guys haven't really tried yet, so can't count that. That's it for now. Go down and take a look at the view that we've got here. This is such a beautiful place. Bowron Lakes. We've got snow-capped mountains, gorgeous lakes, and lots of rain. All the rain you can handle. Thank you.
Okay, take off my stupid hat.
Taking off his stupid hat, man, he hates that hat.
Yeah. Good morning on day 3. Yeah. We woke up to rain and low cloud. And Bryce didn't want to eat his eggs because they're disgusting. He learned that yesterday.
Yeah.
So Cliff choked back the eggs today, so staying close to shore.
Yeah, you're going to do that.
Nick's finished his paperwork for the day? Yeah. Okay. And, yeah, so we finished up breakfast, got all the gear down, and loaded the boats and get out on the water. Another day of wet, rainy paddling. Well, that's it for now. Hopefully the sun comes out and we can film more later. Okay, day 3. We are leaving campsite number 20, heading for 27 or 28. And the rain has let up for now. So, onward we move. The plan for today is to finish Isaac, set up camp at the end, and then practice in the chute. Try to run it a few times with empty boats before we have to do it for real tomorrow with full loads. Yeah, we can always portage it if we decide we don't want to do it. The lake is calm today. It's beautiful so far. It's been the whole minute. How's everyone's shoulder feeling today?
It's alright.
Same here.
Mine is feeling slightly fixed every little bit. My shoulder's feeling.
Yeah. We're all feeling it and it's only day 3. Oh. That's it for now. I'll check in later. Well, I don't know how well you can hear over the rain, but the rain really picked up, so I'm just lounging in the hammock. That's the view outside. Rain's coming down, but I'm dry and comfy in here. The other boys are sitting under the tarp over there. We were going to play in the chute this afternoon, but right now we'll just have to wait this out. Hopefully it's a short storm. Ryan's over there chilling.
Hi, camera people.
The hammock guy's got it going on, I'll tell you that much. So, how have the first 3 days been for you?
God awful, no. my arm is really hurting from the portages.
Yeah, they were long.
Other than that, I guess good. Sleeping in the hammock is really good.
That's good. It looks like your hammock is a bit too short. Like, are you not bent when you lie in that? Maybe we need to lengthen that ridge line a little. Can you get a flat? Oh no, you're okay. Sort of.
Okay, so it's been good other than our misfortunes today?
Yeah.
Good. That's good.
The people in the group site are from Calgary.
Yes, yeah, there's people in the group site right behind us here. That's twice we've been here that we've had people from Calgary. They were from Calgary last time we were at this site.
They?
Yeah. Okay, well, thanks. Other than oops on the river, how's the first 3 days been?
Good.
We got to catch the viewers up because they missed it. It's in the bottom of the Isaac River.
Maybe we can find it.
We would love to find it. We'd be so happy if we could find it.
Maybe cast it out. Catch it.
Try to snag it. I don't think there's anything to snag. The case broke off pretty good. So how are the portages for you? Bit rough?
The one was rough, but other than that, it was good.
Yeah? Paddling was okay today. Mm-hmm. We got to sail a little bit. Okay, anything you want to say?
Nope.
You want to say, sorry I knocked the GoPro off, viewers? I'm sure he is. I don't blame him. It's not his fault. I shouldn't have had it where I had it, I guess. But that's the risk you take when you're trying to get a high action shot for the YouTube viewers. Mm-hmm. Would have been some good footage. Okay. Thank you, sir. Tell me about how the first 3 days have been for you.
Hey, what's wrong?
It's rolling.
So, first day, pretty well. I mean, kind of not so nice portage, but it was the better of the, two or three we've done now?
Two.
Two. Better than the two.
Okay. And then, we've done three. You're right. Three. Sorry.
Yeah.
Yeah. The first one was better, yeah?
Yeah. And then it was the longest. And then paddled across a nice little, I wouldn't really call it a lake, kind of a pond, but it's what, Kiwi?
Kibby Lake, something like that.
It wasn't very long.
Yeah.
And another portage, which was a pain. That one was, the most difficult?
I think so.
Yeah.
It was 2 kilometers and it was pretty bumpy and muddy. And
then we canoed to about the end of Indian Point Lake, where we stayed in a nice little cabin, had some nice bunks. Mike hung up in a hammock and Cliff tented, and then us boys we just slept in the cabin. It was pretty nice, played cards. Then we got up the next day and canoed to just through the little bit at the end of Indian Point Lake we had left, and then portaged again. To the west arm of Isaac Lake, where we canoed to our next camp.
That's right. Yeah, last night you guys were in a cabin again.
Again, yeah. Not the comfiest, as I only had 6 inches of room between me and the roof. But it was nice. Bryce slept on the floor.
Yeah.
And then
that's probably why he's taking a nap now.
Didn't have a very good sleep. And then we canoed for a while. Tried to do a little bit of sailing. Worked semi-decently.
Yeah, we got up to 4 kilometers an hour.
Yeah. And then it started raining again like it has been the entire trip. But nice-ish now.
Yeah, hopefully it stays nice and we can keep this camera rolling.
And it's been a half-decent trip so far.
So the river behind these guys is the chute, and that is where I lost the GoPro.
Yeah, so we were standing here, doing a little bit of fishing in the run here that is the chute, essentially. And these guys ran through, everything was looking really good, and then we thought that
something, there was a crack, and then something fell out of the canoe, and we thought that it might have been that Mike dropped his paddle, and we were thinking, oh, okay, yeah, whatever.
And then the cursing started.
Back. You can go get by with one paddle. And then all of a sudden we see that they both had paddles, and then, yeah, it was kind of sorted out that it was the GoPro from the other guys who were on the shore, and thought it was a lost cause, actually.
Yeah, it's pretty fast water down there.
It's pretty fast, and it's really, really deep. Like, it's hard to say, but once it gets into the middle, it's so deep you can't even see the bottom. And I figure it's probably upwards of 30 feet deep, easily. And so
with the current, too. So,
and so we
really don't know.
We thought it was a lost cause, but then we decided to go through, paddle through the chute just for fun before dinner. And ended up floating around in the tailout of the run there. And we're looking down, and Luke goes, look, I think that's it.
Yeah.
And yeah, so Luke's looking down,
and just see the little square of the screen pointing up, you know, the little light gray square.
Yeah, exactly. I think it's a part of the case. Like, there's two white bars on the case, and that's what really stood out.
Yeah.
And we paddled around, talked to Mike, and figured we just jumped in and went for it.
And he saved my trip. He saved my video. I owe these guys so much.
So. It was kind of fun. It was a good little adventure. Got the adrenaline going for me. That's for sure. Yeah.
So it's Mark and
Luke.
Well, thanks a lot, guys.
No problem.
I'll give you my YouTube channel, and you can check out the footage when I get it all edited together. And so, thanks a lot.
Have a great trip. Yeah.
Okay, thanks. You're not cold because you can't feel anything.
There's no such thing as cold in Canada.
Are you filming?
Cold at all.
Yeah. And then I'll pan up here and show them what's behind you.
Now you see me. Now you don't.
Hi, Kick.
My hair's all still.
And here's a tour of this site. I got the hammock set up over here. Bear cache is there. Nick's walrus. Magnus, Cliff. A whole bunch of other people. So we're on Lanesi Lake. We're about 3/4 of the way down. Sun's finally come out, so I can risk having the GoPro out for a change. Since I don't really have the waterproof case. I have it, but I can't hold on to it. It doesn't have a mount anymore, so. So this is Lanesi Lake. Day five?
Yeah.
Day five. 3 to go. We didn't get a lot of film. Oh, Nick's doing his famous upside down paddle. We're not going to move very fast. I didn't film a lot the last day of the river because I didn't have a way to keep the camera dry.
and it has been downpouring. You can see by these clouds, I mean, it's just been brutal. But today is starting to shape up, so I'm gonna put this away so we can catch up to the guys. We're gonna head to the end of this lake, a little rest break there, and then push on to Sandy Lake to camp. Sandy Lake, and it's definitely sandy and rocky, and for the first time in the trip, quite buggy. I guess we had bugs at the beginning, but the last few days have been pretty good. So,
because it's sunny.
Yes,
raining.
Finally. Mm-hmm. For now, it's not looking like it's going to be that way for long. So hopefully I can dry my stuff out and then get it packed away. How's your day been, Magnus? Pretty chill. Bryce?
Pretty good.
Yeah. What do you think of the trip so far? We're just past halfway.
Yeah, it's been pretty good so far. I really like the canoeing and the portages. It's been a little bit, but it's been alright so far.
Yeah, the rest of the portages from here are easy. That last one was the worst. Absolute worst. Right, Nick?
Yeah.
I think he says that every time until we get up to the next portage, and then it's like, oh, yeah.
No, Nick and I said the one, we said the one along the Isaac River is brutal, the second one there. That up and over, we said that right from the start. So, they get shorter. That's what I've been saying. Shorter.
Shorter. Not necessarily better, just shorter.
Yeah. Well, the next one, I don't remember being that bad. So you guys are going swimming again?
I am. Probably.
Doesn't look like Bryce is ready.
And the bug won't be out there.
Yeah. Okay, well, I'm going to eat lunch. There's Nick doing the dance. Do a dab. There we go. The dab master in the water. Ryan's running away, but I can pan faster. It is cold water. Ah, Ryan done film. Bugs! Nick never did his bugs thing again at that other camp.
Oh. We're gonna have to go back to there.
Yeah. Maybe next time. I got bug biting my back.
Oh, there's a bug on my leg. Oh, there's blood on my. Oh, what yeah. Was that poem right here?
I don't remember. It's like 10 bug lines.
The poem wasn't. The poem was like 3 lines.
The lines were short, but there was many lines.
You were doing many lines?
Said repeat.
No, that was a song. That was a poem.
That one's a poem.
No, the song was...
The song is the one on the song you never read.
Yeah.
This is the
lay one back to my never end. This goes on and on, my friend. That birch bark, just a sizzling. That's the sap in it. I'm so pale right here. It's sort of like a light.
But hopefully, I'll have it all settled next week.
Yeah. There's Ryan making his biscuits. Nick and I are making a thing of bannock.
Yeah,
Nick's hiding behind the tree. There he is. Oh, dab. It's a gorgeous night on the lake. It's So Ryan.
Hola.
Hola, day 6. Caribou Falls.
Yep.
Babcock Lake Portage. Skoy Lake Portage. Another day of rain. Nothing better than waking up to gray skies and sprinkling rain.
You mean I didn't wake up to that?
Well, no, you just woke up to gray skies. So yeah, Ryan was the first one up today, first one packed. First one eaten. Yeah. So anyway, this is Sandy Lake and we're about to head off for start day 6. From here we hit the Caribou River into Una Lake. We'll hike into the Caribou Falls. Then back up the Caribou River and into Babcock Creek. And a 1.2 portage to Babcock Lake, which is a fairly small lake, to a little 400 meter portage into Skoy, another 400 meter into Spectacle. And then we're gonna find a spot somewhere up there to camp. Tomorrow we get to the end of the Bowron River and Saturday we're out of here.
We're out of here.
Where did the week go? Oof. And we're still hoping that we're going to wake up one day to a nice sunny sky, but I'm thinking that that's not happening. Anyways, I am covered in no-see-ums, so I'm putting this away until I check in later. So this is the trail to Caribou Falls. How long did you guys say it was? 1.5 kilometer walk. And it's quite pleasant. Okay, so we're at Caribou Falls, taking a few pictures. And this is what you do not want to paddle over. This is why when we leave Una Lake, we paddle hard. So, gonna head back up, paddle up the river, and look for a campsite for today. Okay, Magnus, you've made it to Pat's Point. You are about 17 kilometers from the end. How does it feel?
Tired. Very tired.
Yeah, today was pretty brutal.
After we passed this place and got beached on a sandbar, and then had to turn around, and then presumed to hit the sandbar again.
Nick?
What?
How do you feel? You're almost completed your second time around the Bowron Lakes.
Good. There's blue sky.
There's blue sky? Well, it's about time there's some blue sky. And Bryce, how do you feel?
I feel pretty good.
Yeah?
He's happy! Yeah,
my shoulder's a little sore, but besides that, I'm good.
Yeah, mine too. Oh, here comes Ryan.
Walk him out.
Don't walk him out.
Hola.
Hola, Ryan.
Hola, senor.
So, We figured we're about 17 kilometers from the end. How do you feel?
Can we just go straight out tomorrow?
Yeah.
Well,
maybe.
People have been talking about it. Not me, but these guys. But
how
we wouldn't be going home.
How many kilometers have we been doing daily, roughly?
We've been doing 15 to 20 every day.
Yeah.
I really don't want to.
If it's spooky tomorrow, I wouldn't mind going out. If it's nice, I'd rather stay.
Yeah, you're still camping, and then you got to pay to camp. That's the problem.
True.
We should just do a hotel.
Haha, we don't have that much money.
What, do you think we're rolling in bank, Nick?
Nick thinks he is.
I am.
Okay, well, this is one of the shelters at Pat's Point. Bowron Lakes weather. Rain. Now it's still raining. So there's a shelter. We got cliff set up over there. We've got a hammock there. Magnus and Bryce with Ryan in the other hammock and Nick in the back there. But here comes the rain again. Time to turn off the camera. One quick video. Captain's log. Stardate day 7. Nick has eaten his eggs. He'll be gassy and farty the rest of the day. Ryan wants to go home.
I want to go home.
Cliff and I want to avoid home at all costs because there's
been
work
there.
There's work there. Been there. Yeah. The weather is cloudy with a chance of cloudier. Yeah. Okay, and the bugs are bad.
Well, it's day 7. We made it to camp today by 10 o'clock. It's just gonna be a short day. So, the sun's finally come out enough that that I can get the cameras out. So I'll try to do a little bit of filming today. Take some pictures around the campsite. And lounge around in the hammock, maybe do a little fishing. See, Ryan's over there in his hammock having a swing. So the other boys are sitting around the campfire pit. They haven't lit a fire yet, but sitting around chatting. And we're expecting a bunch of people that we met. We met so many people on this trip. Just give a shout out to Beast from Seattle. That was his trail name. He hiked the Pacific Crest Trail and the Appalachian Trail. And we met him canoeing here. They shared a site with us one night. His name was Beast, or Brian, right, Ryan?
Yeah.
Brian from Seattle, or Beast, if you hiked the PCT in 2003. So we met him and his wife. We met a group of adults from Vernon. There's a family here now from Kamloops. We met a couple from North Vancouver. Ahead of us today, pushing all the way out today, was another group. I think they're from Vancouver as well. I hung up with them a little bit last night. We met a couple of guys from Israel. Didn't get their names. And some people from Switzerland. Two older couples from Switzerland. I met lots of people. I think a bunch of them are going to be meeting up here tonight for the last night. So hopefully they make it this far. And we'll have maybe one big group campfire before we go.
So guys, day 8.
Burger time.
Yeah, quick breakfast, 3-hour paddle through the fog.
Paddling like pulled pork, pulled pork, pulled pork. Wow!
What to eat? I have a big decision here on day 8. I got scrambled eggs with ham and green peppers, or scrambled eggs and ham and green peppers. And I don't know which one to choose. I think I might go with scrambled eggs and ham and green peppers.
I think it's a good idea.
Yeah.
I think that's a good choice. Okay, so we're here on the side of the Bowron River waiting for Ryan and Bryce to go back and check the cabin. Ryan realized he may have forgot something. We're hoping the sun is going to burn through this cloud. It's probably going to be a hot day once we hit the lake. We're hoping to see some moose this morning, but I think we're too late. The Boy Scout troop from Seattle's already gone through, and the couple from North Van has already gone through. And the young family from Kamloops has gone through. So. We'll just watch Cliff and Magnus try to paddle around here. Okay, Cliff.
Some salt and pepper.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Give us the first bite here.
You want the first bite?
First real food after 8 days on the lakes. Worth it?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.